One of the things you have to take into consideration with Excel is the fact that it returns data, not as individual values, but very often in arrays. You can see on this screen I have a simple query for the tag sinusoid, and I've brought back 17 values. But if you click in any of these fields, you'll notice in the formula bar that it's actually showing me the data link formula, not the actual values. And if it appears, or if the program thinks I'm trying to change any part of this array, it'll give me this message: you cannot change part of an array. And you'll notice that once you get into this loop, anywhere you click on the spreadsheet, you'll get that error message. So you'll need to press the escape key on the keyboard to get out of that error. Now, if you'd like to use these numbers for any purpose other than the data link spreadsheet, or you need to send these results to somebody that doesn't have data link, you can copy the entire array and paste it. But what you need to do is be very, very careful. You don't just select paste, because that'll just paste the data link array as well. You need to use the paste special function and paste only the values. And that will give you just the values. Now, you'll notice sometimes you'll get this formatting here, and that formatting will be alterable in the format cells, where you can alter it to be a date function. And if I alter it to be this function right here, I will get the same or the equivalent display as I received over here. But you will notice that these events or these values in the cells are actual data. Now, you'll also come into the come under the situation once perhaps where you'll have to propagate a formula. Here's a very quick formula I did. It's using the pi archive value function, and this will retrieve a single value from the archive. And if you're familiar with Excel, you can see that you can drag a formula down and it will propagate the formula through the area that you dragged. However, you'll notice here that it did not seem to propagate the formula. My tag name is still pointing at cell A6. And so, and the reason it does that is because there are absolute cell references. And the absolute cell reference can be altered in your example or in your display before you do the propagation. Let me erase my propagation so I can go back and edit the array. And I can go and take out the dollar signs in that portion of the array to allow me to have that be not an absolute reference, or in other words, allow it to be a relative reference, so my dragging option will work. Now, you'll also notice that when you try to press enter here, you get the same message: you cannot change part of an array. And the little trick here to changing part of an array is you need to press the shift control enter keys. That will force your change into the array and allow you to then take your formula bar, or take your little tab here, and drag it down. That will propagate the formula correctly. You'll notice as I click through this in the formula bar, the references are changing. So we generally recommend that if you do need to change an array, any part of an array, that you do it with the right mouse click and select the third item down. This will bring up the original dialog box as you populated it. However, if you do need to somehow adjust an array, and you do need to change it in the formula bar, you can do that. You just need to use the Control Shift Enter key combination, and that will allow your change to propagate through. And remember, if you ever get stuck in an array change, just remember to press the escape key to get out of that loop. Keep in mind when working with data link and arrays, when you retrieve a range of values, in this case I've gotten values for the last 4 hours for my tag CDT158, and I have 41 values that were returned, and I can scroll down and verify that. If I change the query time to return something less than the original, the array in DataLink, even though the number of values returned is less, in this case by almost half, or a little more than half, the array is the same size. And there is a setting in the Pi settings dialog box to display the NA instead of blanks. And that's what this does. Without having that checked, these cells would simply be blank, even though the array would be the entire cell range down to row 51, these would appear as blanks. Sometimes that can mess up the way you fill in spreadsheets and cause issues with that. So a lot of people like to use the NA instead of blanks to have that filled in so the entire length of the array has something in it.